Bonjour, I'm Pierre from French Moments, and in this video, I'll take you for a walk in the village of Eygalières in Provence. We'll explore the village to the top of the rocky outcrop, which offers a magnificent panorama of the Alpilles. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. It really supports the channel and helps us bring more amazing content to you. Also, if you haven't already, click on the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you never miss out on our latest videos. Let's begin our tour of Eygalières from the town hall to the south of the village. The town hall was built in 1912, marking the modernization of the village and the fact that Eygalières had expanded beyond the perched village. This is where the Provençal market is held every Friday morning. Here one can find all the local produce, fruits and vegetables from Provence, cheeses, oil, honey and more. We're going to join the Rue de la République. Here's the main crossroads of the village. To the left, Avenue Léon Blum leads to the free car park where I parked my car. Here's the Fontaine de la République, overlooking the impasse de la Vieille Fontaine. The fountain, dating back to 1900, is topped with Marianne and pays tribute to the French Republic. Let's continue our stroll along the Rue de la République. This is where you will find the shops and restaurants of Eygalières. Since I'm walking during lunchtime, most of these shops are closed, as is the tradition in France. Eygalières is a lively village that has been fortunate enough to keep its shops open. Thus, you will find a bakery, a butcher, a greengrocer, a cheese shop, a delicatessen, a mini market, a newsagent, real estate agencies, a pharmacy, the public library, and the tourist office where you can find all the practical information for staying in Eygalières. Here we are at the Place de l'Église. The Saint-Laurent church was inaugurated for Christmas 1905 to replace the old church of the upper village. The Catholic church is in the neo-Romanesque style and its wrought iron bell tower was installed at the end of the 20th century. We now enter the old village via the Rue du Docteur Roch Johannes, which serves as the high street of the village. The street gently slopes up to the top of the village, marked by the site of the old castle. During the discovery of the old village, the eye is constantly drawn to the pretty ancient houses along the winding alleys, the fountains, washhouses, and oratories. The street runs alongside beautiful houses with sculpted doors. It's interesting to note that here the facades do not display pastel tones because they reflect the very limestone rock of the Alpilles. It feels like being in the Provençal nativity scene setting. At the very top, we catch a glimpse of the clock tower, which we'll visit later. We are going to take this path on the right that climbs towards the clock tower at the top of the rocky promontory. Here's the Tour de l'Horloge, or Clock Tower. Come on, a few more steps and we'll be rewarded with a magnificent panoramic view. Look at this panorama. In front of us stretches the village of Eygalières and the Alpilles mountain range. The Tour de l'Horloge dates from the end of the 17th century and was built with stones from the old feudal castle in ruins. The clock tower is a symbol of independence for the inhabitants of Eygalières. Once Duke Henry II of Guise, the landowner of Eygalières, was imprisoned by the Spaniards in Segovia in 1653. He appealed to his subjects to provide the sum needed for his release. The ransom was paid, but the Duke could not or would not repay it. He preferred to give the lands of Eygalières to the region's farmers. The bell tolls the hours with its 19th century mechanical clock. It weighs about 350 kilograms and strikes the musical note B. Here are the ruins of the old feudal castle. It consisted of four round towers and a keep protecting the village from dangers with a 360 degrees view of the surroundings. The part that remains today is the first level of the keep, which used to be a guard room. The statue of the Virgin Mary was placed there in 1893 to commemorate a miracle that tradition holds occurred that same year. And here's another panorama to the east of the village towards Orgon. Alright, let's go explore the surroundings of the summit. Directly in front of us stands Mont Ventoux, and in the foreground the ruins of the Tour du Prieur. This is a windmill in ruins dating back to the 17th century. A clergyman converted it into a dovecote at the beginning of the 18th century. Here we have a truly Provençal ambience with these pines. Here's the Chapel of the White Penitents. It was built in 1581. It served as a charnel house during the plague of 1720 because the penitents were tasked with burying the victims there. Once the Brotherhood was dissolved, the chapel was left abandoned, and it was restored in 1947 by the Association Les Amis du Vieil Eygalières to house the Museum of Vieil Eygalières. Let's go see the view to the north of the village. Here's the breathtaking panorama over the Comtat Plain towards Avignon. Let's continue the exploration with the old Saint-Laurent church. The old Saint-Laurent church is Romanesque and dates from the 12th century. It was built with ashlar stones and a slate roof. During the Revolution, its bell tower was destroyed and then rebuilt a few years later under the Second Empire, but it never got its bell back. This old parish church was replaced in 1905 by the new Saint-Laurent church, which we saw at the bottom of the village. Today, it hosts artistic and cultural events. And now we return to the old village. Some houses are still in ruins. Here we are again on the high street that we climbed earlier. We will descend it for about 100 meters. On the right is the Hotel Isnard. It's a beautiful Renaissance mansion built in 1542 by Pierre Isnard, a lawyer at the Parliament of Provence and a member of one of the most prominent families of the village. Since this mansion was the most beautiful house in the village, it was nicknamed Le Château by the people of Eygalières. On the left, here's the Calvary of Place Saint-Christol. It's a monumental cross from the early 18th century. Here's the Place des Pago-Tard. It's a small square created at the end of the 18th century in place of the fortified gate of Saint-Christol. This is where the village market used to be held a long time ago. We will now take Rue Paveneuve. A word about the Place des Pago-Tard that we crossed earlier. The small square refers to the inhabitants of the perched village. As the relative political and social stability settled around the 16th century, the built-up area of Eygalières gradually extended towards the plain to the south. The last occupants of the upper town were agricultural workers. These were the most modest populations who did not have the means to build a new home and who only paid their debts after the harvest, hence their nickname of Pago-Tard or Paye-Tard in French, which means late payers. On the left, we see the corner tower of the ramparts, which is behind the Hotel Isnard, in front of which we passed a few minutes ago. Rue Paveneuve is a very picturesque street lined with beautiful old estates, many of which have been restored and some rented as holiday homes. The street is the ancient Chemin Roumieux, or the road to Rome. This is where the GR653D Pilgrim's Way to Santiago de Compostela passes through today. Here we are at the intersection with the Rue des Écoles. If you take a left, you will return to the village via the new church, but we're going to turn right because I want to show you a place that is little visited but worth the detour. Look at this beautiful blue sky of Provence. We're going to leave the street to take the rocky path that climbs on the right. We are approaching our goal. Here are the ruins of the old Puy de Marin windmill, dating from the early 18th century, which was located outside the village ramparts. There is a 360-degree panoramic view of the plain and the Alpilles and Eygalières below. We can clearly see the castle hill and clock tower on which we were earlier. In front of us stands the corner tower of the ramparts, which was transformed into a dovecote. Here's the interior of the old mill, completely in ruins. We're going to explore the surroundings. Wow, look at these cacti. It's a pretty picture of the old medieval ramparts of Eygalières. We will now rejoin the top of the village with this sublime view of the plain and Mont Ventoux in the distance. Let's turn right onto the chemin de la grotte de Tarascon. We're going to enter the upper part of the old village through the ancient Porte de l'Oro. Oro means wind in Provençal. The fortified gate owed its name to the mistral wind that gusted through it. And here we are again on the high street, which we have climbed and descended already. Come on, we'll take a little detour through the Rue Safranière before continuing the descent. It's a dead-end street, but it features some pretty stone houses and beautiful elements of the small heritage. Let's retrace our steps. We'll pass under the Calvary and continue the descent of the high street. There's not a soul in the streets, and you may ask why. It's because it's lunchtime and people are at home or eating at restaurants. That's why I prefer to do my filmed walks at this time. Let's take a peek inside the church. And by the way, you can see me in the reflection of the glass. The interior is neo-Romanesque, and because the church is relatively recent, there isn't really any architectural interest. Come on, let's cross the Place de l'Église and head towards the shopping street. This is where the village is most lively. Before filming, we ate at this restaurant, which I recommend. If you're watching this on YouTube and you've been to Eygalières and the Alpilles, I'd love to hear about your visit. Drop a comment below and tell us what you loved about it. Sometimes you get pleasant surprises when visiting a Provençal village. We had the opportunity to take a Citroën 2CV excursion in the Luberon, which was an unforgettable experience. And here we are back at the town hall at the end of our discovery tour. But before we finish this video, we're going to take the car to visit a must-see place in the surroundings of Eygalières. Here's the site of the Saint-Sixte chapel, 1.4 kilometers from the village. The chapel is located in an ancient place of worship dedicated to water. Its name refers to Sixtus II, a 3rd century pope of Greek origin. Sixtus II was beheaded in 258 AD during the persecutions led by Emperor Valerian. In the distance, you can see the perched village of Eygalières against the backdrop of the Alpilles. The chapel is placed on a mound and framed by cypress trees. You have surely already seen it in coffee table books or tourist brochures. It's an iconic image of Provence and also of Provençal Romanesque art. The first reference to the Saint-Sixte chapel dates from 1155. Originally, its facade was the bell wall, which still exists today. The porch was added in 1629 to shelter the numerous pilgrims. Unfortunately, you cannot visit the interior except during the heritage days. Like many churches and chapels in Provence, they are victims of vandalism, which leads to their closure to protect them. From here, we have a beautiful view of the sanctuary. The chapel was completed by a small monastery attached to the church and surrounded by a low wall. And there you have the little guided tour of the Saint-Sixte Chapel of Eygalières. Thank you for watching this video. It was a real pleasure to bring you along on my discovery walk in the village of Eygalières and the Saint-Sixte Chapel in Provence. I'll see you soon for other adventures. À bientôt!